How to be successful with AI, and especially, of course, with Gen AI. I'm here with Thomas Christensen. You're the VP Ecosystems at IBM. You speak to many small, larger organizations that start with Gen AI. How are they successful, and why are they successful?
So we're talking about AI for business here at IBM, and it's all about having a plan, trying to think end-to-end about what you want to accomplish, because at the end of the day, it's about the business outcome. So it starts with the model. We have our Granite model, but we work through many other models as well. Finding the appropriate model is the first step. Not just taking the biggest one or a conventional, but maybe a foundation model for exactly the things you are trying to accomplish and the industry you are in. Second step is about the data. So what data do you need to put into the models? So a study says that only 1% of the models has enterprise data in them. We need to make sure we can infuse more enterprise data to make them relevant for businesses. And by the way, also protect the data. So we ensure that your data stays your data.
Correct.
So in the governance as the last step, it's super, super important that you put the right governance around, both in terms of what industry you're in, what rules there may be in your country or in the EU, so you ensure that you get the results from AI, but in a secure fashion. That's crucial, and that's what we provide in the WatsonX family. So the models, you have those in using the models you want. You have the data under control and can infuse the data that is relevant, and you can put governance around it. That's the WatsonX suite, if you will.
And we have another part, which is the people, of course, where you can do it all on your own. Yeah. You have to figure it out on your own, trial and error. Or you can work with partners. What kind of models do you see working best? What are most fast and what give the best business results?
No, for sure, we believe in the ecosystem not everybody knows everything. So that's why we need an ecosystem, right? Team up with the ones that has knowledge, expertise, specialist expertise that you need for your project. At IBM, we use our client engineering teams a lot together with our partners and clients to team up and by using design thinking and other great methodology to figure out exactly how to make a successful project. So I believe in general that if you use the ecosystem, you not only get to better results, you also get there faster and you get to outcomes, which is typically delivering more business value.
Yeah, and they have the experience often already if you work with partners. And then the last part, you were talking about these successful projects. Can you share some projects?
Yeah, I mean, so we do across our different partners, we do share the success stories that we see. I've shared at many of our partner events the story of iTromsø, a journalist media company in Norway, who is transforming journalism with Gen AI and with WatsonX to ensure that the journalists actually spend the time doing critical journalism work instead of trivial articles that they have to do. They do that now with Gen AI. So we see with partners, for instance, like in Netherlands with Migrato, with partners like Cogniware in Czech, that they have used WatsonX.data to extract different types of data that is needed in a specific industry or public sector, massive amounts of documents, and they, you could say, wash all of those documents before they process them or use them in other applications. That is, I would say, probably one of the most big use cases we see right now in the WatsonX.
But there are so many use cases. Everywhere has data. Basically, there's a use case, and every company needs to define where to start. What's the best use case? Which data do they have already? Enterprise data.
Exactly.
And that's where they can start.
I just want to mention, if I may, we have a concept called IBM Client Zero, because we actually applied this to ourselves. So what better way to start than use technology yourself? So we really want to invite everyone, also looking at this, to join us and listen to what IBM did in HR, in finance, and in so many other verticals in the business to automate and optimize with AI and with automation software to deliver huge savings, but also optimize for IBMers, for our clients and partners. So IBM Client Zero.
Learn already from what's already there. So why invent the wheel every time over and over again?
Exactly.
Thomas, thanks a lot. Great insights.
Great to have you.
Thank you for watching here from Brussels. Look forward to seeing you again.
Thank you.